everyone. I'm Tara from Pure Impact Fitness in Beaton, and I just wanted to offer a little short segment for all of my forever fierce people over 65, okay? I know that there's a lot of high intensity workouts, including mine, out there, but there are a few exercises that I think are completely essential. You can always do those higher intensity interval workouts, take it down a notch, go to a regressed version to build strength and to build power. But what is so important is keeping your core coordination and balance and your legs and upper body strong, okay? The foundation for that is learning how to use your pelvic floor muscles, making sure you have good balance, and attacking those muscles. So I am going to give you my top four exercises that I think you should do every other day. You can time it, so you could do a 30-second interval, a 50-second interval. You could also count out, you know, one, anywhere between 12 and 20 reps. It really depends on where you're at, okay? So my first exercise that's one of my most favorite is called a bird dog. I'll show you a few different angles, okay? And what it is you have wrists underneath your shoulders, okay? And then you have knees underneath your hips. Body weight is forward, and you're making sure you've got that pelvic floor on. So your back doesn't look like this. You have those abdominal muscles contracted, toes are underneath your heels. Now, there's several different ways to attack this, so I want you to really focus first and foremost on this bird dog position here, okay? Once you've rocked this, you can start to lift. And what I want you to do, even if it's tiny bit off the floor, and then back down, tiny bit off the floor. Otherwise, you can go all the way up. And what you can also do is go up and add the leg, okay? So you have this balance going. You don't want to be tipping, so the goal is if you have to, just do one arm first, and then you can go up with the leg. And then work towards being able to go here nice and slow, gather your balance, lift, okay? You want your leg to be in line with your body, not way up here, okay? Because that's going to cause your torso to rotate. Showing you again from this angle, making sure that pelvic floor is on, lift, and down, okay? Slower, the better. Exercise number two, hip bridges. Heels underneath your knees, arms down next to you, palms up, okay? And that's just so you can't push your hands into the floor. And up you go, exhale up, inhale down. Now I want you to come all the way down to the floor for a level one attack at this exercise, making sure you've got those pelvic floor muscles contracted, right? It's like you're trying to close the belly button, pin the back to the floor. Exhale up, keeping that contraction. When you're at the top, the goal, and not to say that's gonna happen right away, but the goal is to have your knees, hips, and shoulders in alignment, okay? And then inhale down. Another trick I like is I like to tell you to come on up, find that beautiful engagement, and then imagine you have a magnetic pull coming from your heels to your glutes. And that's gonna just rock those hamstrings on, okay? Now, if you're feeling a little bit stronger, you can exhale up, inhale down, but don't hit the floor all the way. And then exhale up. Okay? So work towards whatever you can, but the goal is to get up as high as you can, but obviously not compromising and pushing yourself up. So if your high is here, as long as you're contracting all those muscles, you will get here, okay? Super, super important. Number three, low plank, okay? Now, that means my elbows are underneath my shoulders, forearms are down, palms are down, and level one would be here. So you can see that my knees, hips, and shoulders are in alignment. I'm not dropping my hips here. I'm also not here, okay? Because if you go through that movement, you're gonna see that neither is working. So if I'm here, my core has to work. And then once that's strong, you're getting 20, 30 seconds, come up to your toes. You can also attack the toes by coming up to the toes, squeezing tight for 3, 2, and then back to the knees for maybe 10 or 15, and then attack the 3, 2. Or stay here the whole time. As long as you're not dropping here,
And as long as you're not here and you're keeping that alignment happening, this is working your core muscles. Okay? Another one that I really, really love. Now, I'm going to use a ball to show you this today because I'm at my studio and I don't have chairs here. But ideally, at home right now, a chair is perfect. Okay? What I want you to do is stand in front of the chair and I want you to sit down and then I want you to stand up. Literally. I just don't want you to sit down and hang out. I want you to exhale up, inhale down. And then what I want you to think about when you're doing this though, is I want you to think about sitting back and down. So you'll see that when I came down, my knees did not go beyond my toes. That's huge. So what I don't want you to do is this type of thing and lift your heel. You're gonna come back, shoulders back. I like hands in the front, exhale up. When you come up, I want you to go back to that pelvic floor activation, glutes on, inhale down, exhale up, okay? And the way you can take this up, as those legs and those core muscles get a little stronger, is you can come here and just tap the chair and come up. So then you're not actually sitting down, okay? Now, if you're at stage one and you need a little bit of help, then get to that chair, come down, and then just use your hands to help you up a little bit, push back. But don't compromise those core muscles, okay? So that is those top four for now. I want you guys to work on those. I'm happy to do this again, so do not forget to give me feedback. You wanna cycle through those four exercises 3 times, and remember, you can go from a minimum of 20 seconds per exercise to a maximum of 50 seconds. You can take whatever rest you need in between, okay? These are very core strengthening exercises, rehabilitative, some balance. We can get into even more balance once you're doing this regularly. But the important part is that you are making that connection with those core muscles. That is the real deal, okay? That's what keeps us from having a fall and, you know, having further injuries from that we never really are able to come back from, okay? Quick reminder as well, with the reps, you can go from 10 to 20 reps as well, okay? If you're getting 20 reps, but you're at a modified version, you know at that point that you need to take that progression, okay? And just as a reminder, your core muscles are not just your abs, okay? This is the misconception for most people. Your core muscles are all parts of your abs, so rectus abdominis, internal, external obliques, lower abs, upper abs, everything. But as well, your low back and your glutes. So that's why you hear me talk about contracting those glutes so much, okay? So I hope that this video was helpful for you. I hope that you're able to take it, really lock down those exercises, focus on the breathing, focus on the core interaction. And I wanna hear from you. So please let me know that you're doing this, how you're doing. A few weeks down the road, I wanna hear about your progression, how you're feeling, what seconds have you worked up to? Okay, if you're brand new to me, definitely reach out. But more importantly, if you have any questions, I'm happy to help answer those questions. So just find me on social media, ask me anything. I am happy to help you. I want nothing more than to build a proper foundation for you so you can be forever fierce always. Thanks for being here.